Hi students, today we will deal with the transfer function of field controlled DC motor. In one of my classes, I have discussed about the transfer function of armature controlled DC motor, and you have gone through the steps of armature controlled DC motor, and we have derived the equation for transfer function of armature controlled DC motor, and also we have drawn the block diagram for armature controlled DC motor. And next, this is like to that section. So this is transfer function of field controlled DC motor. Okay, in this case DC motor is field controlled. So the speed of DC motor is directly proportional to the armature voltage and inversely proportional to the flux. And here we are dealing with the field controlled DC motor. In this type of motor, the armature voltage is kept constant and the speed is varied by varying the flux of the machine. Since we are dealing with the field controlled DC motor, we are assuming that the armature voltage is kept constant. So the speed is varied by varying the flux of the machine. Since flux is directly proportional to the field current, the flux is varied by varying the field current. And the speed control system here is an electromechanical control system, and the electrical system consists of armature and field circuit. But for analysis, we are considering only the field circuit is because here we are assuming that armature is excited by a constant voltage. So we are dealing with only the field circuit. Okay. The mechanical system consists of the rotating part of the motor and the load connected to the shaft of the motor. The field controlled DC motor speed control system is shown in the figure. And this is the speed control system. And here the electrical part and mechanical part are shown. And the electrical part consisting of the field circuit, and that contains a resistance RF, inductance LF, and exciting voltage VF. And also in the armature section, there is a current IA. And also the mechanical part consists of the motor load, that consisting of J and B, and theta is the displacement. So the various quantities marked here are RF, that is the field resistance, and LF is the field inductance, and IF is the field current, and VF is the field voltage, T is the torque developed by the motor, KTF is the torque constant, J is the moment of inertia of the rotor and load, and B is the frictional coefficient of rotor and load. So we can start the analysis. We know that the equivalent circuit of the field is constituted by the field resistance and the field inductance. Okay, so we can draw the equivalent circuit like this, and which is shown in the figure 1.3. That is, this is the figure. So it consists of resistance RF and inductance LF, and the exciting voltage is VF, and the current through this is IF, and due to that current, the voltage drop across RF is IF into RF. And also the voltage drop across the inductance is LF into DIF divided by BT. So we can write the Newton's equations in this case. Since we are dealing with the electrical circuit, we can write the KVL equations for this circuit. So by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law to this circuit, we will get IF into RF plus LF into DIF by DT equal to VF. That is equation number 1.25. So this is the equation that we got after applying Kirchhoff's voltage law to this circuit. And also the torque of the DC motor is proportional to the product of the flux and armature current. And the armature current is constant here. So the torque is directly proportional to the flux alone. That means flux is proportional to the field current. So we can write the torque is proportional to the field current. So we can write the equation as T directly proportional to IF. So torque will be equal to T equal to KTF into IF. So that is the torque equation. And next we will consider the mechanical part. Mechanical system consists of a moment of inertia J and B, friction showing component B. And the mechanical system will be governed by a differential equation. And we will get the differential equation by writing the equation j into d square theta by dt square plus b into d theta by dt equal to t, where t is the applied torque and theta is the displacement corresponding to that applied torque, j is the moment of inertia and b is the frictional coefficient. So we can write the equations as j into d square theta by dt square plus b into d theta by dt equal to t. Actually we are getting this equation from Newton's second law of motion, okay, applied sum of algebraic sum of opposing force equal to applied force. So we will get the equation 1.27, and we can write the Laplace transform of various time domain signals. So we will get the Laplace transform of if equal to if of force s, Laplace transform of t equal to t of s, Laplace transform of vf equal to vf of s, Laplace transform of theta equal to theta of s. So we can have the differential equations governing the field controlled DC motors as we have the equations, that is, one is RF into IF plus LF into DIF divided by DT equal to VT, that is first equation. Second equation is KTF into IF, T equal to KTF into IF. Next equation is J into D square theta by DT square plus B into D theta by DT equal to T. This is the equations that governing the DC motor, flux field controlled DC motor. So we can take the Laplace transform of each and every equation. So we will get RF into IF of S plus LF into S into IF of S equal to VF of S. Similarly, T of S is equal to KTF into IF of S. And next equation will give the Laplace transform as J into S square into theta of S plus B into S into theta of S is equal to T of S. So we can number each of these equations, and in this textbook it is written as 1.28, 1.29 and 1.30, and these are the three equations. In this equation, 1.29 equation and 1.30 equation are equal, okay, both of them gives T of S quantity, so we can equate those two equations, okay. So we will get JS square theta of S plus BS into theta of S is equal to KTF into IF of S. So we will get the, by equating those two equations, we will get the KTF into IF of S is equal to JS square of theta of S plus BS into theta of S. And in that equation, we will get IF of S by taking KTF to the denominator of that equation. So we will get IF of S is equal to JS square theta of S plus BS theta of S divided by KTF. In that, S and theta of S can be taken outside. So we will get IF of S is equal to S into JS plus B into theta of S divided by KTF. And also we have equation 1.28. Whereas 1.28 gives RF into IF of S plus LF into S into IF of S is equal to VF of S. In that equation we can take IF of S outside. So we will get IF of S into RF plus LF into S is equal to VF of S, okay. From 1.28 we can be written by taking IF of S outside, we will get the equation RF of S, RF plus S into LF into IF of S is equal to VF of S. We have got the value of IF of S from the equation 1.31, and we can substitute that 1.31 equation into 1.32 equation. So we will get instead of IF of S, we are writing the equation that is given in 1.31. So we will get RF plus S into LF into S into JS plus B divided by KTF into theta of S is equal to VF of S. Okay. So substituting the value of IF of S from equation 1.31 in equation 1.32, we will get this value. And in this equation, you know that it contains theta of S, which is output, and also the input is VF of S. So we can write it as a transfer function, that is output by input, that is theta of S divided by VF of S is equal to KTF divided by S into RF plus S into LF into JS plus beta. So this is equation for theta of S by VF of S, and we can rearrange this equation as KTF divided by S into, in the first term we can take RF outside, so it will become 1 plus S LF divided by RF. And in the second term, we are taking B outside, so we will get 1 plus S into J by B. So that can be written as KM divided by S into 1 plus STF plus 1 plus STM. where Km equal to KTF by Rf into B, that is motor gain constant, and Tf is equal to LF divided by Rf, that is field time constant, and next Tm is J by B, that is mechanical time constant. So we got the transfer function of field controlled DC motor. Okay, so the steps for getting the transfer function or for getting the differential equations are similar as what we have discussed in the case of armature controlled DC motor. But in the case of armature controlled DC motor, we are taking that field circuit is constant, so we are neglecting that part. And here in this case, that is in field controlled DC motor, armature voltage is taking as constant. We are considering only the field circuit. Okay, this is all about this topic. Thank you.